There you are.
Now we're good. Okay, sorry about that. Little mix up with devices. So, good morning, everybody. A couple of things real quick before we get started. As always, thank you for joining me. Thank you for joining any platform that you join, whether on Zoom here or watching it on YouTube. One thing to note is that as we kind of work through this sequence, there's a new moon on Monday, so we're going to work kind of low and up and then come all the way back down. And so if you know that when we do bind stuff, you like to have a little bit more length, so a strap, a blanket. I use a Brooks Brothers power tie, which is the only reason I ever use this tie. So any of those things are kind of perfect for it. And so we're going to get started here in child's pose. And what we're essentially going to do is kind of keep moving and building through the sequence as we rise up. So child's pose starts. So big toes together, knees as wide as the mat. Take a moment. Settle your elbows all the way down onto the mat, your forehead all the way down onto the mat. Do some space for your belly, for your chest. Pretty quickly here, go into your breath. Noticing the length of your inhale, the depth of your exhale. Take a moment to notice the ground underneath you. Your hands, your elbows, your forehead, tops of your knees, tops of your feet. We'll pressure back towards your heels. Slowing your breath down, let's take three breaths together to initiate the practice. Take a deep inhale through your nose, fill your body up with air, feel your lungs expand. When you get to the top, open your mouth, exhale, let air all the way back out. Again, take a nice deep inhale all the way in. A nice exhale all the way out. Third breath. Exhale. From here, walk your hands forward on the mat. Take just your fingertips down to the mat. Let your elbows come away from the mat. Drop your forehead. Inhale, walk your hands. Let your heels and your knees come together. Leave your hips directly above your knees. Walk your hands forward. Drop your forehead and your chest down towards the mat. Find puppy. So a combination of down dog and child pose. Find some length through your arm. Press down through your arm. Exhale, walk your hands back towards your feet. Let your hips come all the way down to your heels. Reach all the way around. Grab the bottoms of your feet. Drop your forehead down to the mat. Walk your hands forward. One more time, walk all the way forward into puppy. Drop your forehead and your chest down towards the mat. This time, with the inner edge of your elbow down to the mat, bring your hands behind your head. Press your chest down towards the mat. As you found length in that first puppy, see if you can find a little depth here. Exhale your hands back down to the mat. Walk your hands back underneath your shoulder. From here, grounding down into your left hand, reach your right hand up to the sky. Exhale, sweep your right hand all the way through. Dip your right temple down to the mat. The
dips down into that right shoulder.
Bring your right hand back underneath your shoulder. Press up to tabletop. From here, take your right foot long behind you. Press out through your right heel. Roll out your ankle 3 times. Other direction 3 times. From here, step your right foot all the way through. Find your heel underneath your ankle, underneath your knee. Press down into your right shin. Keep walking that foot forward. From there, shift your weight back into your left knee. Ground your right heel. Bring your right toes up to the sky, half split. Just early, seeing where your hamstrings are, see how you feel. Slowly bend back into your right knee, walk your hands forward. Bring both of your hands to your right knee. Press down into your right shin. From there, bring both of your hands behind your head. Interlace your fingers. Press back in your hands, look up to the sky. Exhale your hands back down to the mat. From here, curl your left toes under. Bring your knee up off the mat. Step your left foot to the top of the mat. Inhale up halfway. Bring your hands to your shins or your thighs. Press back. Exhale back down. Step your right foot to the back of the mat. Take it backwards. Step. Ground the top of your right foot. Ground your knee. Bring both of your hands to your left knee. Press down into your left shin. Feel that hip engage. From here, bring your hands up overhead. Interlace your fingers the weird way behind your head. Look up to the sky. Exhale back down to the mat. Walk your hands back to your right knee. Ground your left heel. Bring your toes up to the sky. Half split. Bend back into your left knee. Step your left foot back behind you. Roll out your ankle 3 times. Other way, 3 times. Bring your left knee back down to the mat. Bring your left hand up to the sky. Exhale, take your left hand all the way through. Dip your left temple down to the mat. Find your breath. Bring your left hand back underneath your shoulder. Bring your toes together, your knees as wide as the mat. Just all the way back. Child's pose. This time we're gonna walk our hands forward. Find puppy. Exhale down to the mat. As you inhale, walk your hands back underneath your shoulder. Curl your toes under, press back into your heels. Lift to down dog. Take a nice inhale. As you exhale, drop your knees down to the mat. Ground the tops of your feet. Walk your hands back towards your knees. Rise up to the hero's pose. Now, if you want from here, if you want a little extra padding underneath your knee, you can roll your mat over. I don't really need it on the surface I'm on right now. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to pivot a little bit so you can see kind of what I'm doing. From here, we're going to inhale our hands up towards the sky. As you exhale, drop your right hand down all the way to the mat. Let your fingertips find the mat. Take your left hand to the sky. Take your gaze up to your left. As you exhale, bring your left hand down to the mat. Bring your right hand up. Exhale, right hand down. Left hand. Exhale. This time, as our right hand comes down, we're going to pause. Ground your palm, bend a little more depth. Lift through that left side body. Keep your left sit bone down into your left heel. Inhale. Left hand down, right hand up. Exhale back down to the mat. Walk your hands forward, find tabletop. Take your right foot long behind you. This time, bend your knee. We're gonna open our knee up towards the side. Take it out the hip height. We're gonna drop our knee down to touch our other. Then we're gonna bring our knee wide. Then we're gonna bring our right foot back up to the sky. Then we're gonna step our right foot all the way through. Press down and lower hip. Ah, we skip shoulders. Step your right foot back. I knew I'd skip. All right, left hand to the sky. Left hand all the way through. This time, make your right hand long in front of you. Press down into your right armpit. At the same time, you press down into your left arm. Right hand back underneath. Take your left hand back down to the mat. This time, take your right foot long behind you. Bend your knee. Open your knee up wide. Take it out to hip height. Put your knee down to your knee. Open up wide. Bring your right foot back up to the sky. Step your right foot all the way through. This time, we're going to cat-cow. So what we're going to do is we're going to inhale, look forward. Then we're going to exhale, curl out our spine, straighten out our right leg. Five times. Nice long inhale. Find the strength through your hamstring and knees. Three more. One more. As you bend back into your right knee, bring both of your hands to your right knee. Just down into your right shin. Inhale your hands up overhead. This time, take your left hand to the back of your right shoulder, then the back of your left shoulder. Take your right hand, touch your left elbow. Press your left elbow down towards the mat. Rest your head back into your elbow. Look up. Exhale your hands back down to the mat. Curl your left toe under. Bring your knee up off the mat. Step your left foot forward. Inhale up halfway, bring your hands to your shins, to your thigh. Exhale, pull. Ground into your feet, sweep your hands by your side, rise all the way up. Put your palms overhead, look through your thumb. Exhale, up for center. Inhale, bring your hands up to the left. Exhale, up for center. One more time. Inhale up. Pause for a second, put your thumbs over your heart. If you want, you can close your eyes, close your breath. Take a deep inhale through your nose. Exhale, your hands down by your hips. Inhale, bring your hands up over the hips. Exhale, hands through the hips, fold all the way down to the mat. Inhale, halfway. Plant your hands, step just your right foot to the back of the mat. So your left heel is underneath your left ankle, underneath your left knee. Drop your right knee. Bring both of your hands to your left knee. Press down to your left shin. Inhale your hands up overhead. Right hand back of left shoulder. Back of right shoulder. Left hand right elbow. Press down. We find that opening first. Exhale your hands back down to the mat. Cat cow. So inhale, look forward. Exhale, curl out. Inhale, forward. Exhale, curl. Three more. Two more. One more. Then back into your left knee, step your left foot back. Ground down into your left hand, reach your right hand. Sweep your right hand all the way through, drop your right temple. Take your left hand long in front of you. Press down into each armpit, breathe there. Left hand back underneath your shoulder. Right hand back underneath your shoulder. Keep your left foot long behind you. Keep your foot in towards your bum. Open up to hips height. Touch your knee down to your knee. open back up to hips height, bring your foot back up to the sky, drop your knee all the way down to the mat, take your big toe together, your knees wide, press all the way back.
Child's pose.
Walk your hands forward. Find puppy, knees together, press down into your chest. Walk your hands back, curl your toes under, all the way back, down dog. From there, with control, drop your knees down to the mat, ground the tops of your feet, sit back in the hero's pose. All right, this time we're gonna add on to it a little bit. So what we're going to do is we're gonna rise up under our knees first, then we're gonna take our right foot wide. You're gonna make sure the outer edge of your foot is still grounded down. Inhale your hands up. Then as you exhale, you're gonna reach your right hand down your right leg, reach your left hand up towards the sky. Inhale your hands up. Exhale your hands to heart center. Drop your right knee, take your left foot long. Again, make sure you can ground the outer edge of your left foot. Inhale your hands up. Drop your left hand down your left leg, reach your right hand. Exhale. Bring both of your hands to heart center. Bring both of your knees to the mat. From there, inhale, bring your hands up towards the sky. Pinch through the hips, fold back down to the mat. Ground down into your right hand. Reach your left hand up to the sky. This time, as you bring your left hand through, press down into your left temple. Then press back into your right hand. Take your left hand wide. Press your left hand down to the mat. Drop your left temple. Maybe this is enough for you. Maybe you reach back with your right foot. Maybe you reach back with your left foot. Maybe you roll to your side. Maybe your right foot reaches back behind you. Everybody come all the way back around. So you find yourself all the way back in tabletop. From there, take your right foot long behind you. Kick your right foot in towards your bum. Open up towards the side. Stack your knee. Touch knee. Open up wide. From there, reach your right foot all the way around your left. Ground the ball of your foot down to the mat. Look back around your left shoulder. Press into the outer edge of your right hip. From there, bring your right foot long behind you. Step your right foot all the way through. One cat cow. Inhale, look up. Exhale out. Bend back into that right knee. Curl your left toes under. Bring both of your hands to your right knee. Put down into your right shin. Inhale, rise up overhead. From here, you're going to reach your left hand long in front of you, your right hand back behind you. Find a twist. Stay long through that left heel. Engage through the right shin. Inhale, bring your hands up overhead. Exhale, sweep your hands down to the mat. Frame your right foot. Step your left foot forward. Inhale, up halfway. Exhale, forward. Let's bring in Utkatasana with one breath in, just for kind of practice. Heel toe your feet together. Leave your heels in line. We can sit there. Inhale, sit back into Utkatasana. Exhale, stand tall. Bring your hands up to the center. Inhale, sit back. Exhale, fold all the way down to the mat. Inhale, halfway. Plant your hands, switch to your right foot to the back of the mat. Find your left heel underneath your left ankle, underneath your left knee. Bring both of your hands to your left knee. Press down into your shin. Inhale, your hands up overhead. Bring your right hand long in front of you, your left hand long behind you. Keep pressing out through that right heel. Find your breath. Inhale your hands up overhead. Exhale, sweep down to the mat. Ground your right knee. Ground the top of your right foot. One cat cow. Inhale, come forward. Exhale, come back. Then back into your left knee. From here, take your left foot long behind you. Let it hover at hips height. kick your knee. Open up to the side, drop knee to knee. Open up to the side, bring your left foot back up to the sky, cross your left foot over your right. Ground into the ball of your foot, look back around your right shoulder. Left foot back long behind you, drop your knee. Inhale your right hand up in the sky. Sweep it through first. Then press down into your left hand. Take your right hand long out to the side. That can be enough. That can be the pose. Maybe from there, you step your feet back. Maybe you lower your body. Maybe you roll onto your side. Whatever makes sense. Come back around. Bring your hands underneath your shoulders. Bring your eyes up onto your knees. Bring your big toes together. Your knees as wide as the mat. Twist all the way back. Tile. Walk your feet, hands forward. Find tucking. Exhale all the way back. Curl your toes under. Press back down. Five breaths this time. See how you feel, see where you are. Little length of the side body, a little breath, a little depth. Exhale, drop your knees back down to the mat. Ground into your shins, rise up onto your knee. All right, adding onto that gate pose, we're gonna take our right foot long to the side. This time we're going to reach our right hand up to the sky. As you exhale, you're going to let your left hand come down to the mat. This can be the pose. You can stay here. You can bring your gaze down to the left hand. Gripping your thumb and your pointer finger, you can let your right foot float back behind you. Find your breath. The next option is to bend your right knee. Reach back with your right hand. Grab your right foot. Line your knee up with your shoulder. Press out through your right hip. Right hand back up to the sky, right foot long. Exhale back down. Inhale, rise up, drop your right knee. All right, other side. Left foot long. Left hand up to the sky. Right hand down. Let the right fingers point away. Grip into that hand. Find that length of the arc. That can be the pose. Great pose. Find your breath. Maybe your left foot floats. Maybe you reach back, you grab your left foot. Whatever makes sense. Rise all the way back up. Bring your hands up overhead. Drop your left knee down to the mat. Drop your hands to heart center. Inhale, bring your hands up overhead. Hinge through the hips, fold back down to the mat. Find your hands underneath your shoulders. From here, curl your toes under. Press all the way back, down, down. Find your breath. Inhale, bring your heels towards the sky. Exhale, bend your knees up towards the mat. Step or pose, top of the mat. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, four. Exhale. Rise all the way up. Touch your palms overhead. Look up through your thumb. Exhale. That's in. All right. We're going to take one kind of opening into Malasana. So, what we're going to do is we're going to offer each pose, we're going to hold for three variations. And so if we come to a variation and you really want to hold it, then just hold that first pose, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to start with our finger toes hip distance apart. So you should be able to get two fists between the balls of your feet. Second toe in line with your heel. Inhale, bring your hands up your head. Then as you exhale, hinge all the way down to the mat. Bend your knees. Drop your chest down to your knees. Reach your hands back behind your ankles. Grab the backs of your ankles from there. Lift through the crown of your head. Or sorry, lift through your hips. Drop through the crown of your head. Let go of the backs of your ankles. Rise up halfway. Bring your hands to your shin. Press out through your hips. Okay, so you can grab the backs of your ankles again. Totally fine. Second option, toe grasp. Peace fingers around your big toes. Palms face in forward. Bending into your elbow. Drop to the crown of your head. Let go of your toes. Inhale up halfway. All right, third set of five reps. So 15 in total here. This one, you can either take toe grasp, you can grab the backs of your ankle. You can grab your opposite biceps and sway a little bit, or you can take gorilla, rocking back on your heels. Let your toes find your wrist, the ball of your foot finds your palm. Any one of those three. Lift through your hips. Inhale halfway. Exhale fold. All right, one Utkatasana here. We'll hold it for five breaths. You can heel toe your feet together or leave your heels in line with your feet. Sitting back, give your heels, reach your hand to the sky. Take your gaze up, drop through your shoulder. Exhale, stand tall, bring your hands to the heart center. Step to the top of the mat. Step your left foot back a third of the way. We're going to set up pyramid. So we're going to go pyramid, standing split, to handstand practice. So if you want to do pyramid three times, that's totally cool. You'll just hold it for five breaths, for 15 breaths. We're going to start by bringing both of our hips forward so they're in line. Open up your right foot. Find your second toe in line with your heel. Inhale, your hands up overhead. Biceps to your ears. Thumb and pointer finger together strong. Take your hands over to the right. Take your hands over to the left. Come back to center. Inhale, look up. Exhale, halfway down. Reach your hands on front. Reach that length. Reach that down. Exhale, come all the way back up. From there, bend into your right knee. Let your hands come all the way down to the ground. When you find the ground, start to work on straightening out your right leg. Drop to the crown of your head. Shift your weight back into your right hip. If that feels good through your hamstrings, if you're losing your breath a little bit, or if you need a little bit more depth in this front pose, you stay here. If you want the next variation, you're going to bring your right hand and your left hand to the back of your right ankle. From there, you're going to reach your left foot back up to the sky. You're going to bend your elbows, bring your arms back behind your legs. Press out through that right hip. Again, you can hang out here. You can take pyramid again. Or you bring both of your hands underneath your shoulders. You rock your weight forward. So your arms are long. Your thumbs and your pointer fingers are gripped down to the mat. You reach your left foot up towards the sky. And then you reach your right foot up off the mat as well. Take it five times. Everybody step your left foot to meet your right. Inhale, rise all the way up. Exhale out. All right, other side. Right foot back. Left foot forward. Second toe in line with heel, right hip around. Everything lines up. Hands up overhead. And realize your fingers the weird way, biceps to your ears. Hands over to the right. Hands over to the left. Back up to center. Inhale, look up to the sky. Exhale, reach your hands out in front as you reach long. Inhale, all the way back up. Bend into your left knee. Let your hands come down to the mat. Bring your left foot. Straighten out your left leg. Drop to the crown of your head. Bring your left hand to the back of your left ankle. Bring your right hand to the back of your left ankle. Shift your weight into your left foot. Reach your right foot back behind you. All right, you can stay here, or you can bring both of your hands out in front. Again, shift your weight forward, find length through your arms. From there, just let that left foot float a little bit up off the mat. One, two, three, four. Step your right foot to meet your left. Inhale, rise up. Exhale out. Inhale, bring your hands up overhead. Pinch through the hips, fold all the way onto the mat. Inhale, halfway. Plant your hands, step back to plank pose. If you like chaturanga, if that's in your practice, then take a chaturanga here. Or simply press your way back to down dog. Either or. Five breaths, then we meet in down dog. Either stepping one foot at a time or hopping, we're going to find malasana, landing our feet outside of our hands. Your choice. Drop your hips down towards the mat. Bring your elbows inside of your knee. All right, so again, three variations. You can hold this variation. Feels good today, right? This is, if it does, let's stay here. No reason to move forward. Listen to your breath. From there, bring your thumbs to your third eye. Lift your hip 2 inches. Again, third variation, but only if you need to. It's Kapasana. So hands down to the mat. Bend your elbows. Stack your knees into your elbows. I know a lot of people like to do it a little bit deeper into their tricep. I'm telling you right now, for different variations, it's easier. You learn this practice, knees into elbows. From there, bring your hands down to the mat. Grip your thumb and your pointer finger. Bend your elbows. Shift your weight forward. Bring one foot up at a time. Then bring your feet together behind you. Find your breath. Feet back down to the mat. Come all the way back to malasana. Everybody bring your hands all the way down to the mat. Step back to plank. Again, if you're a chaturanga person, feel free. Or just let your breath press you back to down dog. Everybody bring your right foot up to the sky. Step your right foot all the way through. Drop your left heel. We're going to rise up into warrior two. Now, if you grabbed that strap earlier in class, because you knew you needed it for the bind, then put that strap just off the upper left corner of your mat. We're going to bend down into our right knee. Establish the sequence with your breath in warrior two. So bind at equal length. From here, turn your right toes in, leaving that bend in your right knee, hinge forward, Let your hands come all the way down to the mat. From there, turning your right toes forward, walk your hand around your right foot, grab the outer edge of your right ankle, reach your left hand up and over, side angle pose. Bring your right hand long as well. Let both hands hover long in front of you. From there, bring your right hand in front of your right leg. If you're grabbing the strap, go ahead and grab the strap. Reach your left hand underneath, back behind you. Find bound side angle, opening up through your left shoulder. From there, straight on your right leg, bound Trikonasana. And a little more length into that hamstring. Take your gaze down towards the ground. Shift your weight into your right foot, bending your right knee. Let your left foot float back behind you. Bound half moon. This is a tough pose, right? We're working it. We open up through our left shoulder, through our left hip. We find our breath. Three more breaths here. Then hinging forward, let your left foot meet your right. Drop your strap down to the mat. We're gonna step our left foot back. Dropping our left heel, we're gonna find warrior two. Now we're gonna take half moon non-bound. So what we'll do is we'll drop our right elbow down to our right knee. Bring your left hand up to the sky. Take your gaze down to the ground. Find the ground. About 8 inches in front of your right foot. Then open up through your left shoulder, through your left hip. Drop your left hand down from the mat. Drop your left foot. Inhale up halfway. Exhale, plant your hands, step our foot back to plank. Chaturanga if you wish. Or just back to down dog. Find your breath. Inhale your left foot up to the sky. Step your left foot all the way through. Drop your right heel, rise up. Warrior two. Back. And we'll switch so you can see me on the video. Set up that strap. Bend your left knee, warrior two pose. Turn your left toes in. Leaving that bend in your left knee, let your hands come down towards the mat. Walk your hands around your left toes. Bring your left toes forward. Bring your right hand up and over. Right angle pose. Let your left hand hover as well. Let your left hand come down in front of your left leg. Reach your right hand back behind you. Work bound side angle. Open up through your right shoulder. Straighten out your left leg. Which he knows. Bound Trikonasana.
gaze down to the ground. Shift your weight into your left toes. Let your right foot float back behind you. Bound half moon. Work your breath. Even when your breath fails you, step your right foot up to meet your left. Drop your step. Step your right foot back. Drop your right heel. Warrior two. All right. Last balance pose. Half moon on the side. Drop your left elbow down to your left knee. That can be enough. Maybe your left hand comes long in front of you as well. Rise up. Let your right hand come down. Let your right foot come down. Inhale, rise all the way up. Bring your hands up overhead. Exhale, heart center. Bring your hands up overhead. Exhale, heart center. Third breath. Inhale up. Exhale out. Put your thumbs over your heart. Close your eyes. If that's it. You can bring your hands overhead. And through the hips, fold all the way back down to the mat. From here, I'm going to take us through a half pigeon. If you have lower back or knee issues, I'm going to ask you to do figure four pose instead. If half pigeon is in your practice, go for it. And if you're coming to figure four, then you're going to come down to your bum. You're going to bend your knees. Line your heels up with your sit bones. Reach out and touch your heels. Bring your right foot up. Press your right foot over your left. You can press down into your thigh, or you can reach through. Either or. Lots of different options. Make sure the back of your head stays grounded. If you're coming to half pigeon, it's easiest to do through down dog. Right foot to the sky. Right knee, right elbow. Right foot, left armpit. Settle down into your right chin. Take your left leg long behind you. Settle down into your forearms. If you want, you can stack fist on fist and drop your forehead down to your fists. If you want, you can drop your forehead all the way down to the mat, whatever makes the most sense. Find your breath. So down into your hips. No rush. No hurry. About five more breaths here. Without rushing, without hurrying, with control, move your way to the other side. Whether it's one leg at a time, whether it's through down dog, whatever makes the most sense. Find your way all the way back. Let your breath guide you into the other side. Thank you.
Take about five more breaths here. No rush. No hurry. The energy of the practice helps open up your hips. Walk your hands back towards your shins. Let your left hip come down to the mat. If you want to take it through down dog, go ahead.
If you're already down in a seated position, then stay there. From down dog, we're going to come all the way down to our backs. Whatever. Whatever gets you there. As you find your back, bring your hands up overhead, reach long. Bring your feet long in front of you by lying from your fingertips to your toe. Exhale, bring your knees into your chest, give yourself a squeeze. From there, ground into the small of your back. Lift your feet straight up towards the sky. Push out through your heels, bring your toes down towards your grounding into your shoulder blades. Lift your hands straight up towards the sky. Check in with yourself here. If there's another pose, another movement, something else you need to complete your practice, feel free to move through it. If that's enough for today, then stay here. Or bend your elbows and your knees 90 degrees. Reach up through your knees, find the bottoms of your feet. Press your heels towards the sky. Bring your knees towards the ground. Happy baby. You want to rock a little bit from side to side, that's fine. Stay active through your heels, your knees towards the ground. There, let the bottoms of your feet come together. Let your feet come down to the mat. Let your knees sway out wide. Seek the body connection. Bring one hand to your heart, one hand to your stomach. If that's enough for you, that's the practice for today. Feel free to stay here or transition to a more traditional Shavasana. As always with these videos, if you need a longer Shavasana, just shut me off. It's cool. The beauty of doing this with technology is that you can kind of make it your own. So own the practice. If you want a more traditional Shavasana pose, take your feet out in front of you, drop your hands down by your hips. Whatever makes sense. Like I said, if you want to log your Shavasana, that's cool. I'll take my 3-part meditation here to seal this practice. Starting first in your body. Be grateful for your body, grateful for what you can do, what you can accomplish. Grateful for the practice, the ability, the time. For your skin, your muscles, your bones, your hair. It makes you you. Be grateful. From there, find your breath. Bring one hand to your heart, one hand to yourself. Use the practice of one breath to let go of judgment, especially of self. Go of the last breath. Release that need to expect the next breath. Wrap your thoughts, your concentration, your breath into one breath at a time, nothing more. From there, roll onto your right hand side with control. Rise up into an easy seated. Inhale your hands up overhead. Exhale your hands to heart center. Touch your thumbs over your heart. Close your eyes if that serves you. Notice your heartbeat. We'll start with one breath together, inhaling through our nose, exhaling out through our mouth. And then we'll take two ohms. A reminder that our words are part of a collective voice, a collective whole. Choose your words carefully. Consider their intention and their impact. Inhale through our nose, exhale out through our mouth. Take a nice deep inhale in. And exhale out. As always, thank you so much for joining me. Any questions or any comments, feel free to reach out to me, leave comments below. As always, happy to share this practice, happy to share with others. Let me know if there's anything else that you need. Thank you so much. Have a lovely day.